After you set up a project in XNAT, one of the first things you might be thinking about is who to grant access to and what kind of access to give to them. There are a couple of mechanisms that we can use in XNAT to manage this process, which we're going to walk through very quickly using our dev instance. Okay, so I'm logged in as myself. This is a new user account that has no admin privileges, and I've just created a new project. So let's navigate to this new project page. At the top of this project is a tab labeled Access. In here you can see a table that lists every person that has access to this project. Right now that's only one person, me, because I'm the one that just set this project up. So let's change that. Below the users table you'll see a couple different ways for adding users to your project. The simplest is just adding users from a list. This brings up a searchable table that simply lists every user in XNAT and lets you assign a role in the project to them. If I search for Carol, I can add her as a member to my project. That means that she'll have the ability to add and edit data in the project, but she won't be able to delete anything. Likewise, I can search for Bucky, add him as a collaborator. He'll be able to see the data and share it into his own project, but he won't be able to edit or delete any data in my project. I can also invite people who have yet to create a user account in this XNAT, as long as I know their email address. So I just need to enter their email address, select a role that I want to assign in this project, and then send the invitation. That user will get the invitation and click the enclosed link that will invite them to either sign into XNAT if they have an account and you just missed it, or register a new account to create a new one. One note is that your XNAT administrator may have to activate that user's new account before they can use it to sign in and join your project. The access panel also makes it easy to remove users from your project or to change their role. Toggling the user role in the menu will change their access level immediately, and it'll ask if you want to send an email confirmation of the change. Likewise, removing a user from your project takes place immediately. In the next lecture, we'll talk about the third option in this access panel, custom user groups.